Hello and welcome to Talk to Us. I'm Avi Arditti.
And I'm Carolyn Presutti from Voice of America. Good to have you with us today.
And we're taking calls on Skype, and we're talking right now to Jamal, who is from Sudan, but going to university in India. Hi, Jamal.
Hello.
Hey, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you're studying in India?
Yeah, I'm studying a Bachelor of Computer Science.
And what
in
year?
MS University in India.
And what year are you, Jamal? Did you just start, or are you almost ready to graduate?
No. Yes, I graduate next year. So now I'm in second year.
And what?
So almost 3 years.
What kind of job do you want to do with computers once you have the degree?
Yeah. When I finish my degree, inshallah, I want to be a network engineer.
Will you stay in India?
Yeah, I'm staying in India. So no, I will leave India to my country when I finish my course.
Oh, so you will go back. Okay.
Yeah.
And help. So what part of Sudan are you from?
I'm from Darfur. You know Darfur?
In the West, certainly. It's in the news a lot. And
in West Sudan.
How are things there? Do you keep in touch with your family in Darfur?
Yeah.
How are things? Why don't you tell us what's life in Darfur like right now?
Life is very bad because, you know, there's some political problem in my country.
Yeah. And
because the life is very bad and it's very dangerous because, you know, there's some fighting going between government and movement. Mm-hmm.
Do you have a lot of people your age who have gone to school in India?
Yes, sir.
A lot of Sudanese.
Sudanese, right.
Are there other Sudanese in school with you? Have you met others?
Yeah, there's many Sudanese.
This is a popular university for Sudanese to go to?
Sorry?
Your university is popular for Sudanese to go to? Is that how you found out about it?
Cannot get you cleared because I think there's some natural problem.
Okay, Jamal, well, thanks for calling. We're going to go to our next call. Is Breeze?
Hi.
Hi, Breeze.
Hi, Breeze.
Yes, I'm Breeze. I'm from Thailand.
Oh, hi.
Did you say you're calling from Thailand?
Yes, I'm from Chiang Mai, Thailand, the north of Thailand.
Chiang Mai.
Welcome. Good to talk to you. I know you're excited to talk to us, too.
I'm so excited now.
What do you do? Are you a student or do you work?
Yes, I am a student.
What are you studying?
Yes, my major is English in Faculty of Education. Maybe in the future I'm going to be a teacher.
Oh, great. Well, this is perfect for you to practice on our Skype show.
Yes, I've been waiting for a long time for Skype with you guys.
Well, tell me, how do you practice your English ordinarily? I mean, what advice? We hear this a lot from callers. They want to know how to practice their English. What do you do to use your English? Do you talk to American or Western friends, or how do you practice?
Yes, when I was high school, I bet that my English was not good. And when I entered to university, I learned a lot. I speak a lot with my friend, and the important thing that I use for improving my English is, the internet, like your website, like YouTube, like everything that I can listen, I can follow them. Yes.
It will be interesting for you to incorporate the internet into your teaching.
Sure.
When you end up teaching English, because that's something very new, learning English through the internet. I would think that your professors didn't do that.
But you can be the next generation. Well, Breeze, listen, good luck to you, and it was nice talking to you. Thanks for calling.
Love your name, Breeze.
Take care. Bye-bye. We're going to go to Armand, is it?
Hi, Armand.
Hello.
Hi, that looks...
Good morning.
Is that you in the photo on Skype there with the huge muscles?
Those are your muscles?
Or is that
I'm from Afghanistan. I am an Afghan speaker.
Whoops.
Whoops.
Yeah, this is my Skype. I'm Ehsan speaking from Afghanistan. Ehsan.
Afghanistan.
Hey, welcome.
You know, we had time.
Yeah, yeah.
Armand, are you aware that there
Hello.
Is a documentary that is up for
right.
an Oscar that was shot in Afghanistan?
It is.
We were.
Yeah.
You know, we have our.
The voice is cutting down.
Oh.
Oh. All right. We'll,
well
try to.
It's yeah, the Booz Kashi boys.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
It was produced in Afghanistan and the U.S. And we can talk about the Oscars. We're gonna go now to Majid. Looks like. Hello, Majid.
Hello, Majid.
Hello.
Hi. Can you hear us?
Hello, Majid.
Hello.
Hi. Can you hear us? Maybe not. Hello. Mm-hmm. Last chance. Okay, we're gonna try calling back. Let's see here. What do I do?
Try call Armand.
Yeah.
From Afghanistan.
Let's try. We'll try Armand back again. Oops.
Yep.
Oh.
Armand, can we call you back to try to get
let's,
a better signal?
Yeah, let's try to call you back, okay? Let's do that and see. Let's put that. We're going to cancel that
him?
Call.
How do you find him then? Oh, there he is. Okay,
yeah.
So he just appears there. Okay.
All right, we're going to try getting a hold of Armand again. Yeah, well, we can also talk to. Here's a caller. Trying to get through to us.
Zwan?
Yeah, let's see. Every once in a while we have some technical problems with Skype calls here where we either have too many coming in and then
nothing.
Yeah, well, it's okay. Here we go. We're gonna try Schwan, who called us a moment ago. Okay, well, let's see if Schwan.
It's a unique picture too. A lot of different.
A lot of nice Skype icon calls.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're going to try Armand one more time.
Armand, are you there?
Okay, hello.
Hi, is this anybody? Oh, there you are.
Oh, wow. There you are for real, instead of just your icon.
You have movie actor looks. Are you an actor?
Do you hear me?
Yeah,
yes.
Can hear you. Can you hear us?
We are complimenting.
Tell me what the problem is. Cutting down.
Oh, well.
So sorry.
That's too bad. Okay.
Trust me. I'd love to talk to you. All right, Armand. We're complimenting you. We aren't making fun. Trust me. Who do we have here? Schwan.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Schwan.
Yes? Can you hear me?
We can
hear you.
Yes.
Where are you calling from?
Oh, I'm from Vietnam.
From
Vietnam.
Yes.
Excellent.
I was there on a short visit in 1990. I remember.
1990.
In Hanoi.
Oh, so
I was in Hanoi for
long times ago.
Long time
yes.
ago.
You need to go back.
Yeah.
I need to go. Of course.
It's changed a lot.
What part of the country do you live in?
I'm living in Hanoi.
Oh, Hanoi.
Okay,
good.
That's right.
Yeah.
Sean, I understand that Vietnam is. After a lot of American tourists, you really
yes.
want the Americans to come visit.
Mm.
Do you work in the tourism industry? Is that your job?
No, I'm working for a social organization.
Mm-hmm. What kind of
yeah.
work? What kind of work does the social organization do?
I'm working for Hanoi Association of People with Disability, and
oh.
I am a social worker.
Excellent. Good job.
Yes.
Very rewarding.
Yes. Thank you.
Very hard.
Well, tell us about, because actually in Special English, we're going to be doing some stories about disability, how people with disabilities get along, you know, get on with life in the U.S. We have an Americans with Disabilities Act. It's a law that is meant to ensure rights for the disabled. Tell us a little bit about what is life like for people with disabilities in Vietnam?
Actually, I'm working for, we are running a project for it by the Denmark, and we focus on raising awareness of people with disability rights and duty. Moreover, we are, at the moment, Vietnamese state Vietnamese government have a lot of policy and laws so that can help people with disability overcome their difficulty and have life better in Vietnam. Mm-hmm.
Well said. Juan, do you mean physical disabilities or mental disabilities?
Or both.
Both.
You work with
all
both.
Kinds of disabilities.
Excellent.
Nice.
Excellent.
Yes.
Well, Juan, thank you for calling, and good luck with your work. We're going to go to Dow. Did I say that right?
Hello. Can you hear us?
Hello.
Good
Hi.
To see you.
Where are you calling from?
I'm from Vietnam.
Oh,
okay.
We just had a caller
like the,
from Vietnam.
Just like the last
You sound very young.
Yes. I'm 20 years old.
I'm sorry. How old again?
I'm 20 years old.
20 years old.
Are you in school?
Yes, I'm student.
And where do you live in Vietnam?
I'm in Hanoi.
Hanoi?
Hanoi.
You know, there's
yes.
there's a controversial news story that we have going on with Vietnam, and that is if Vietnamese eat a lot of beef or not. And there was someone that wrote an article in the New York Times that said that Vietnam is very violent because the people eat beef. And so, of course, everybody is saying, no, that's not true. A lot of Vietnamese eat vegetables, fish, whatever. What do you like?
It's the first I've heard of this. What, do you eat beef or are you vegetarian?
That's fine. You're
That's
learning
okay.
English.
That's,
this is
it's,
the way
listen,
to do
it's
it.
A, it's a, we're, this is kind of a complex topic. I have to go. I'll have to look up that story mm-hmm. in the New York Times. But Dow, thank you for
thank
calling.
You, Dow.
And we're going to. I see we had a call from. I'm going to try this person here. Let's see if we can get through to this caller. Oh, okay, actually, we'll take a call from Tanya.
Oh.
Hi, Tanya.
Hi, Tanya. I love your icon.
Can you hear us? Oh, there you are.
Oh, there you are.
Is that you, Tanya?
Hello.
Speak up a little. Can you a little louder, please?
Hello. Can you hear me now?
A little louder. If you could turn your microphone up.
Okay. Hello. My name is Tanya.
Oh, very good. Now.
Where are you from, Tanya?
I'm from Nicaragua.
Nicaragua. I'm visiting Nicaragua in a couple weeks. We're
going. Oh, really?
Wow,
yeah,
nice.
It's an amazing country.
I'm jealous.
I'm sure you're going to like it.
Where are you? Which city do you live in? Which city in Nicaragua?
I'm living in Managua.
In the capital.
Managua. Yes, we will be going to.
Datos de virus ha sido actualizada.
Oh,
that's a capital of our country. Yeah.
Yes, yes, we're going to Granada.
To Granada, that's amazing. I mean, you're going to love the architectural structures in that place. It's amazing. It's an amazing place, especially for making tourism.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
I'll be visiting a couple schools there in Granada.
Well,
okay.
What do you do, Tanya? Are you in school or do you work?
Well, actually, I'm finishing the university. I'm just finishing my thesis, and so that's the last thing I have to do. I'm studying English, too.
Your English is excellent. You must be getting an A in English.
Thank you.
Is there a binational center in Managua? One of the local, the educational institutions called the binational centers that work with the State Department? Do you have one of those there?
There is an institution called Cornerstone. That's a school of English.
Oh.
So the prices are really low, so I'm learning English in that school. And universities, so well, there are many universities in here, public and private universities, so we can have education.
And what do you want to do when you graduate?
When I graduate, I want to work, it's something related with my career. And I would like to have my own business after I finish all this, after I work there for a short time, and having my own business.
Well,
that's what
who is that we're hearing in the background, if I might ask? It's always fun when we hear kids in the background. Who is that? Someone related to you?
Oh, yeah. Just some kids and some people here.
Okay. Just some kids.
Just some,
some
kids.
People.
All right. Well, Tanya, it was nice talking to you, and maybe you'll...
Yes, I may see you on the street.
That's right. So
take care,
take
Tanya.
Take care. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Well,
see
thanks
you.
For calling.
Bye.
Bye. Okay, we are going to... let's see here if we can get a hold of Najim, who tried calling us when we were talking to Tanya. It's very high tech, right? I'm reaching over to my laptop here.
That's all right.
And
it's live.
It's live. It's exactly.
That's what it's meant to be. Hi, Najim. Are you there?
Well, let's see. It's ringing. Okay. Well, who else
somebody
is?
Somebody else was trying to call in. Let's see.
Oh, I think we have Najim with us. Hello, Najim. Can you hear us? Yeah. Hello.
It's interesting. You hear a little bit in the background, but you're not sure if it's
that's right.
actually connected
that's right.
or if it's just
okay,
static.
Okay, we're
going to
try. This Kader tried calling us. Looks like a. I'll have to see what that drawing is. But
looks like a tree. Maybe the tree of life.
Could
know,
be.
Or maybe it's anatomy. It could be somebody
right.
flailing
you know,
their arms.
You know, we can talk to three people at once or
right,
something. And
right.
we take multiple calls here.
Looks like a conference call, a Skype conference
right.
call.
Right, well, maybe. Okay, so try that. All right, well, so you're going to Nicaragua.
Right,
and you're going to
for
be
10 days.
You're going to be speaking at two schools, you said?
One main school and volunteering time. So it's a long time in Nicaragua, but it'll be great.
All right. Well,
I've never been there.
You have to
been to several Central American countries, but not Nicaragua.
Okay.
Spent time in Panama last year.
Okay. Let's see if we can get a hold of this person.
Qatar.
Okay. Oh, wait. Nope.
Ah.
Looks like.
Like.
Hello. Can you?
Hello.
That's me.
Hello.
I'm hearing my. Hello.
Oh, I will call you back.
Oh, wait.
Okay,
is this Kader?
No, it's Osama.
Oh, okay.
Pakistan.
Well, here, this is, why don't we just talk right now? It sounds like we're,
Oh, I think Kader is also online. Kader is also online.
Oh, I
so
see.
Exciting. So
I think we've actually, created a conference call.
Conference, yeah. Should I call you back?
No, this
no,
is fine.
No, it's fine. We'll talk to both of you.
So tell us a little bit about yourself. Where do you live?
I'm from Pakistan. It's third time I'm talking to you, and it's always good to talk
nice,
with you people.
Yeah.
It's great. Pakistan
yeah.
had some amazing news today. I understand your stock market closed way up.
Amazing
you,
if you
if
make
you
money
invest,
on that. Eric,
right.
if you're invested in the stock market.
I'm not interested in, you know, economics. I'm
oh.
not of that type of economics.
What is
much of my interest is in, you know, politics and
politics.
Pakistan's political situation, which, you know, getting weird and weird with the passage of time. We are tired of this corrupt government, you know. They don't care about their people. They're just busy in making money and, you know, every politician have Swiss accounts. My God, terrorism, people are killing, and, you know, sectarian violence. And you might have heard about, you know, sectarian bomb blast in Quetta, and 89 people
oh.
got killed. Oh, my God.
I know. They were. I've been hearing. We've been following the
right.
news.
Now, you say you're interested in politics. Is that your job, or are you studying politics?
Oh, exactly. That's a good question. Actually, you know, in Pakistan, if you want to be a bureaucrat, if you want to be a part of bureaucracy, so you have to pass an exam. It's called CSS, Central Superior Services of Pakistan.
Uh-huh.
So their subject includes your grip, your command on current affairs, and subjects like that. So it makes you a very knowledgeable person, and, you know, you feel different from other people.
Have you passed?
And for your, you know, you might, you, I read subject history of US, and it's a great subject, you know, to learn about the history of you people. So it's great, you know.
So have you passed that exam?
No, no. Tomorrow is my first exam.
Oh, well, wow. Good luck.
Whoa, you must, let's see, what time is it there right now?
It's 9:49 p.m.
Shouldn't you be asleep? I mean,
maybe you're still studying. No.
Are you still studying for the test? Are you cramming?
That's the term we use.
It's no, you know, it's your tactics. It's your tactics. It depends upon your academic background. It's today because, you know, you need to learn some tactics because tomorrow is my essay writing paper and another is for English grammar, English composition. So, you know.
You're very good at English. You should do well at that.
Oh, thank you. And you know what? You know, it's always a very good experience to talk with someone who is native speaker to learn English from the one who is native speaker because, you know, after my DAT exams, I would appear for my IELTS test. You know IELTS?
Oh, the IELTS, sure, sure.
Yeah, IELTS, yes.
Well, that's why we have the show, so you can speak with us.
Gives you a chance to practice. Well, good luck on your test tomorrow. So take care. We'll talk to you again soon. Okay, we're going now to Salehi.
Salehi.
Are you there?
Beautiful picture of a little girl there.
Cute picture.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe let's try that. Let's see if we can try her back. See if we get through there. If not, we are going to take a call from, okay, Ednio.
Hey.
Hi. Hey, Ednio.
Hi.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Where are you?
Ecuador.
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 We just had a call from Nicaragua.
Really?
Yes. So what do you do in Ecuador?
I study geology.
Geology?
Oh, geology.
Yeah.
Have you been to the Galapagos Islands?
No.
That would be a great place to study geology too, right?
Yeah.
Right off your coast.
Have you been following the news about the rover on Mars? It's doing the collecting the geological samples. You've been seeing about that in the news, but maybe that's big news in the geology world. I don't know.
Geology is about rocks, meaning petroleum.
Oh, yeah, right. Sure. Right. Of course.
That's good. What year are you?
Sorry?
First year student? Second year student?
I in the last level.
Last level?
A senior, you mean, or a master's degree? Or?
Yeah, I'm looking for a master's degree in the United States.
Oh,
very good.
Excellent.
There are some, my roommate in college started out as a geology, he started out computer science, electrical engineering, and then switched to geology, and then became a chiropractor. So, I know. But
do you understand the term chiropractor?
Do you know what that is? Doctor who works with your back and
bones. And tries to readjust your bones certain way.
Well, we are, Ednio, we are getting a lot of calls coming in all of a sudden. So it was nice talking to you, and good luck with completing your studies. We're going to go to Samo.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello, Samo.
Hello.
Where are you?
I am from Algeria.
Algeria.
Nice.
I like your picture. Nice. Your picture has an umbrella and beautiful blue skies with clouds.
Yeah.
Is that you in the picture?
What?
Is that you in that picture?
Holding or someone you know with an umbrella? It's your Skype photo.
I don't understand. Oh. Speak slowly because I am beginner, right?
Sure. Sure. We can speak slowly. Your picture has an umbrella.
Looks like
a
woman holding an umbrella against a blue sky.
Yeah.
Who is that? Someone
Just picture. I don't know.
Oh, he just chose the picture.
So what do you do in Algeria? Do you work or do you go to school?
I am student.
What do you study?
Study English language.
Oh, good. Beginning?
Yeah.
First year? Second
year?
Yeah,
first.
First year.
Good.
I like your page on Facebook.
I'm glad you do. Thank you. Good. Thank you for visiting it.
Why did you choose English to study?
I love it.
Why?
Why?
You need a reason?
I would say it is a nice language.
Okay, great.
Well, Samo, it was nice. Thank you for calling. It was nice calling. Nice talking to you. We've got a few other callers trying to get through here. We're going to take a call from Ghazal.
Hello.
Hi. Hello, Ghazal.
Hi, Ghazal. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Germany.
Germany. Very interesting picture you have on Skype.
Is that you in the photo?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yes. What do you do in Germany?
I'm studying, and actually, I come from Iran, but I live in Germany and I study.
What subject are you studying?
I study at school, so the normal lessons. And
so
yes.
you aren't in college.
You mean like you're studying general subjects right now for your undergraduate or?
Yes, in high school, in the gymnasium.
Oh, okay.
Right, that's why she doesn't have
I see. Okay,
she's younger.
You're younger than I. I thought you were in college or university.
Why did you move, or when did you move from Iran to Germany?
For 2 years. Oh. And, yes. And I started to learn German, and because of that, it's really hard for me to speak English, because always the German words come to my head, yes.
Well, but there's a lot of, I'm trying to think here from the linguistics that I think there's enough similarity that it might not, it might not be so different for the English and the German, the Germanic influence on English. And I know some German words are very long. Right,
yes.
they form compound words that we don't do in English, but
yes,
Gesundheit. When you sneeze, we say that.
That's true. If you sneeze, we say Gesundheit. But so, how do you like it? Have you made a lot of friends in Germany?
Yes, I did, and it's a bit different from Iran, because in Europe, I don't know how is it in America, but I think the people are more friendlier, but here it's they are not so friendly, but there are good people, so it's a little hard in beginning of to have a friendship with them, but now is it easier. Yes.
Do you think the older people in Germany are friendlier, or your high school comrades are friendly?
What do you mean?
Well, do you find that younger people are friendlier to you, younger Germans or older ones?
I think younger ones, and I don't have any problem anymore. So yes, because at the beginning there were different cultures, and I wanted something else, but now it's really good. So I integrate myself, and it's really easier.
Good.
Very good. Big word, too.
Yeah, that's right.
So well,
that's right.
You did well putting that into a sentence.
Well, Ghazal,
good luck to you.
Good luck to you. It's nice. Thank you for calling in, and good luck with your studies. So we're going to talk to Pedro now, looks like.
Pedro. Hi, Pedro.
Can you hear us?
There we go.
Oh, there you go.
Hi, Pedro.
Can you hear us? We see you. Okay.
Uh-oh.
We're going to, let's see.
He had a big smile on his face on his picture.
Sung.
Hi, Sung.
Hello. Okay, we're going to go to Mohammed. Mohammed, can you hear us?
Yes. Hello, this is Mohammed Bilal from Afghanistan.
From Afghanistan. Mohammed,
yes.
We spoke with you before, didn't we?
Have we spoken to you before?
Yes, I think in last week.
Yes,
oh, okay.
For Valentine's Day.
Okay, very good. Did you have a good Valentine's Day? I don't know. I don't remember
Thanks.
What. Good. Okay, Mohammed, well, we've got several other people trying to call here, so we're going to thank you for calling, and we'll talk to you again soon. We're going to go to Mustafa.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, Mustafa.
We're fine, thanks. Good. Thanks for, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm very happy. I'm very happy really to hear the VO Voice of America.
Great.
Right. Where are you calling from?
I'm from Egypt.
And how are things there today?
I think it's a good. Today is my vacation, my day off.
Okay. Yay! Okay, good. Oh, and you're. What time is it there?
Friday is my day off.
And but it's Friday night, right?
What time is it right now? In
7 p.m.
So what are your plans tonight? Because you're off again tomorrow, right? Or so you can stay out late?
Do you work tomorrow or are you off tomorrow?
No, I work tomorrow. Oh. My plan for this night is just watching TV and looking for English website, okay, to get some useful idioms like that.
Useful okay. Idioms.
Well,
yeah.
Well, here's a useful idiom. It's only 7 o'clock. The night is still young.
Yes, that's a good
right?
one.
There you go. How about that? You know, it's
so that means that there are many hours ahead of you, yes. And you can do a lot of things. The night is still young.
Unless,
stay out late.
Unless you have to, as we say, turn in early, meaning go to bed early, right. To because you can't sleep in. Because you have, meaning you can't sleep late because you have to go to work tomorrow.
So that's three idioms.
How about that? There are a lot of.
That's good. Avi's good at all of them.
Well, you know, it's just like so much of everyday speech are these little
right.
idioms,
and
we don't even think about it.
We just say them, and it's just normal conversation. Yeah. So it's good that you look those up on the internet. So the night is young.
Let me say that I'm a social worker. Mm-hmm. I'm 26 years old. I'm looking for get PhD, postgraduate studies in America or England. So now, in the meantime, I'm take English courses with a native speaker here in Luxor. I'm Egypt from Luxor State. Mm-hmm.
Oh,
of course
okay.
You know Luxor.
Luxor, yes,
yes
we know Luxor.
You probably have a lot of opportunities, maybe, to speak to tourists, to travelers. Isn't that a major destination for tourists coming to Egypt, Luxor?
Yes, lots of tourists, yes. I make simple conversation with the foreign people. Really, I like English. I love English language and respect the American nation and Western nation, okay. With you on Yani in the meantime. So forgive me because I'm still my English is not much. My English is not much. Just
you're fine. I'm amazed at how quickly you speak. Usually you speak very slowly when you're first learning, but you speak quickly. You're doing well, Mustafa.
Well, Mustafa, you are going to be our last caller because I'm looking at the clock and we've actually, the night is young for you, but we've run out of time in the room we're in right now. This is actually a room that's used as part of the VOA tour and there's supposed to be a tour group coming through soon. So we're going to wrap up. Thanks for calling. We're going to
wrap up another.
There you go, another idiom. We're
yes.
going to wrap up.
That means we're going to finish.
We're out of time.
Right.
From VOA Learning English, I'm Avi Arditti.
And I'm Carolyn Presutti. Thanks for joining us.
And we'll look for us again on Facebook the next time next week.
Right. Hopefully next Friday.
We'll do another Skype call-in show. Take care.
Take care. Bye bye.